once upon a time, there was a world that was so lost, where they didn't recognize what Jesus Christ did on the cross, where men were the byproducts of what seemed to be an unbreakable chain of generational sin, where they felt like they couldn't win. They were imitations, following the footsteps of their father's fleshy desires as they were being more and more broken within. Assuming that this is who they are, the fornicator, the abuser, the cheater, believing that these are permanent scars, being deceived, and failing to understand that the devil is a liar and a disgrace. But what does God do in this case? Let's see who gets victory at the end. And now let the real truth begin.
All rise for the Honorable Judge Nelson presiding. This court is now in session. You may be seated.
Unmute your mic before you go on.
Yeah. Case number 502, please.
H502,
please your case.
How was I supposed to know? I didn't know she was underage. Why am I even being punished? We live in a society where there is no justice. You can't blame me. I have no father. The only men I knew were the ones my mother let in and out of the house. I may not be the ideal man that you thought I was, so I'm only doing what I know. Doesn't the Bible talk about how God forgives the ignorant anyways?
No. What the Bible says is he is able to deal gently with those who are ignorant and going astray, since he himself is subject to weakness.
Just keep talking.
This is found in Hebrews 5:2. With that being said, I sentence you to a lifetime of wisdom, truth, and knowledge without the possibility of parole. For James 1:5 says, if any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to those without finding fault, and it will be given to you. This case is dismissed. Case number E-524, please plead your case.
You know, it's ironic how I've become the very man I thought I would never be. A man that I call my father. You see, my father was a ruthless man. A man who would beat my mother every single day. Every day. I can remember times as a child where he would ask her to do something and if she didn't move as fast as he wanted her to move or she just didn't feel like moving at that time, he would hit her. Over and over again. My mom loved this man. She devoted her whole life to treat him like a king. I mean, she cooked and cleaned for him, but it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. And then he would quote some scripture to justify his reasons for beating her. Somewhere in the Bible where it says that as the church submits to Christ, so wives should submit to their husbands. As if she didn't submit enough. Now I'm that man today. I guess the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree, huh? Just like my daddy.
You mentioned Ephesians 5:24. What does verse 25 through 27 say? Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up to her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. I'm sensing pain and brokenness from you. Psalms 147:3 says he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. I sentence you to three counts of lifetime healing and forgiveness without the possibility of parole. This case is dismissed. Case number P567. Please plead your case.
Your Honor, at the home. No, I ended up in. This is not me. I made mistakes, yes. But those mistakes do not make me. I take responsibility for all my actions. Man, my father taught me about this. As a man of God, I'm called to be the head, the provider, and the protector. I should follow Christ so I can leave my home. I know that does not make me perfect. For all I have sinned, fall short of the glory of God, and all I justify freely through grace of the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. Whatever my judgment, so be it.
Different heart, huh? 1 Peter 5:6-7 says, humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your anxiety onto him, because he cares for you. You know who you are, and you know who you're meant to be. You also explain that you make mistakes. Continue to humble yourself within the Lord, and he'll make a great kingdom man out of you. I sentence you to freedom in the Lord. May he have his way with you. This case is dismissed. In Psalms 103:13, it says, for as a father has compassion to his children, so the Lord has compassion for those who fear him. Today we celebrate all the stories of all fathers and honor all fathers, especially our Heavenly Father. This court is adjourned.
You see, despite who they were and what they have done, God sent down his one and only precious Son to die and rise up so that all generations can have a fresh start, so that man and sin can be set apart and be free. And the things that were done in the past will be thrown into the depths of the sea, where those sins are no longer taken into account, no matter how large the amount of iniquity. If you are willingly able to accept the simplicity of what Jesus Christ did, then in pours true love from above. Then ears will be able to hear when those words of the Lord have spoken, because you were the one that was chosen. And then the chains and the curses will be broken.
Sickness. Poverty. Anger. Curse is broken.
The enemy is trying to make me believe that my past is who I am, that the mistakes I've made from yesterday is all that I would ever be.
They looked at my family and said I'd be nothing.
They told me I would be nothing. Nobody in my family.
They said,
they said, you're just like your mama, just like your daddy, never amounted to anything.
But I couldn't accept that.
But that's not me.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
God gave me a promise.
God gave me a promise. On that I stand.
So today,
the curse is broken.
I've made some mistakes, but
my past can't hold me.
I felt defeated, but I know now that
I'm more than a conqueror.
I read his word and it's what he told me.
That's what he told me.
so I'm so glad that the curse is broken.
The curse is broken.
I can declare that my body's healed.
My body's healed.
You've got to know that the devil,
the devil's a lie.
And I'm free today because it's in his will.
It's in his will.
Thank you, Jesus. The enemy.
The enemy is trying to make me believe.
My past.
That my past is who I am.
That every mistake I made.
Mistakes I made from yesterday. Is all
certain struggles have been in my family, but listen, it's not me.
It's not who I am.
Oh, God gave me a promise. And that's what I'm standing on today. So somebody just lift your hands and say, the curse is broken. And I know now that my past. I'm so grateful, God, that I'm more than a conqueror. What my mother struggled with, what my father struggled with, it stops with
that's
me.
What
that's what you
told
me. Oh, that's right. The curse is broken.
The curse is broken.
Lay your hands on yourself and say, my body's healed. Don't listen to the enemy because the devil is a liar. He can't change what's in God's will. It's Jesus. Come on, Todd, help me. Say the mistake.
The mistake.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
The lies.
The lies they told.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
My past.
My past. It's not who I am.
Today the curse.
The curse is broken in my
life.
The
I regret it.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
The misfortune you went
the
through.
Misfortune.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
The disease, oh no.
The disease.
That's not who you are.
It's not who I am.
The curse is broken.
The curse is broken.
Come on, say I'm healed.
I'm healed.
That's who I am.
That's who I am.
Say I'm free.
You can now live. Because as soon as you drop to your knees and close your eyes and speak words to agree, to nail your strongholds to that tree, then you'll begin to comprehend that just because your earthly father may not have been in the picture, believe your heavenly father have been painting your picture. Creating a masterpiece just like the man God gave to Eve, making you the father and the husband that you were meant to be.
Created for your glory, I was created. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there in the world.